Hey YouTube, Jeremy here with Simple Little Life, and today is day 12 of the 30-day video challenge. In today's video, we are going to build a Kydex press for making Kydex knife sheaths. Now, I had mentioned in a video I uploaded about a month ago that I was going to build this press. I said I was going to do it next week. Had I done it that next week, this would have been done about 3 weeks ago. But thanks to the motivation of a 30-day video challenge, today I'm all over this. Let's get started. Okay, first, if you are a knife aficionado or you're into guns or tactical stuff or other gear of that nature, you know what Kydex is. For those of you who don't, Kydex is a thermoplastic, and basically when you heat this up, it becomes very malleable and it retains its shape as it cools down. This makes it a great option for things like knife sheaths, pistol holsters, magazine holsters, flashlight holders, you name it, you can make it out of Kydex. I think Kydex is one of the most underutilized materials by DIYers. In fact, I was once going to build a coffee cup holder for my bicycle with Kydex. Great product, it's very inexpensive, and you don't need any fancy tools to work with it. Let's take a look at the materials we're going to use to make this press. Alright, so the idea behind a Kydex press is that you have some foam substrate, and basically you lay your Kydex pieces on top of that when they're warm, and you sandwich it between the foam, and then you need a rigid frame around that to clamp it all together. What I'll be using, this is actually a specialty Kydex foam, and apparently it handles heat better. I'm not all that impressed with it. You can see some of the impressions that have been left from some of the other things I've made. We'll be using this. Previously, I had just used some very inexpensive foam sleeping pad, and it does work. For the framework, I'm actually going to use these two hunks of maple. Now, I have a neighbor who has a friend who works in a cabinet shop, and he has tons of this stuff left over, and he gave me a whole whack of it. These two blocks were the smallest piece that I have, and I probably have like 15 or 20 of these blocks in maple, black walnut, and oak. So that's kind of a cool building material. Since I had it, I thought I might as well use it. I was originally planning on using half-inch steel plate, and I'd been saving these pieces for this press, but this is way too heavy. It would work good, and the bummer with this is it would take a lot of work to modify my hinges for it, so I think wood is a much quicker option. And these hinges are basically hinges that were thrown out where I used to work, and these were off the toolboxes of service trucks. So these should work good. I'm gonna have to make a slight modification to them. So basically, we'll have our bottom frame, our foam, and our top frame, and two hinges on the back side of it. Now, I'm not going to build a clamping system for the front. Some people do like an integrated clamp system. That's just a lot of work that I don't have time for right now. I'm actually just going to keep using a wood clamp. The way I was doing my pressing before was just like you see it here. I would set my piece on here, and then I'd put this down, and I'd clamp this whole thing together. Now, that was kind of difficult. If you had a knife that had like a rounded handle, sometimes it would wobble, and you got to work fairly quickly as the Kydex is cooling, and I found it very difficult. Sometimes I'd go to press one and I found out that I had it in the wrong spot, and that happens because it's hard to hold the knife while you're laying this on top and get it all even. So having hinges on one side will be nice. I'll be able to hold the knife with my hand, bring it down, keep pressure on it, and then put a clamp on. Alright, so I'm going to head outside now. I'm going to cut down these hinges. They're a little bit too long for what I need, and then we'll be drilling our holes in them, screwing these into the wood, gluing our foam together. Very simple project. I'm going to switch cameras right now because I don't want to wreck my nice glass while I'm drilling and grinding, but I'll take you along for every step of the way, and let's get started. So basically this will be how the back or the hinge side of the press will look when it's all done. I'm going to mount this hinge like so. And then obviously I've got to cut this down, drill some more holes, and then we'll pre-drill our holes through the wood, put some screws in it, glue the foam down, we're good to go.
Now these holes, they don't have to be perfect. Got our hinges done. Looks pretty good. And now we need to glue. It's actually nice because those hinges bind a bit and they'll stay open. Now what we need to do is take some Super 77 adhesive and glue these pads to the wood.
Okay guys, I had to switch to the iPhone because my other camera battery died. Dried. Ugh. Perfect. Okay, so I wasn't going to for this video, but I'm actually going to for this video. Okay, let's see what it looks like. My awesome watch. Whew. And you could drill some holes through here, put this on the side of a knife sheath. I don't know. I was just testing it. So even with this thermal foam, I'm getting some depressions in it from the heat, but I guess we'll just have to use it and see.
All right guys, well there you have it, a very simple way to build a Kydex press. And if you're thinking about building one for yourself, just use whatever materials you can come up with, be creative. As long as it's gonna stay fairly flat, and as long as you have a foam that has a decent amount of give to it, you're gonna be fine. The one thing I would highly recommend is hinges on one side. It makes working with Kydex so much easier. And if you've never worked with Kydex, you can tell it's kind of cool stuff. It's highly useful. Use your imagination. There's a ton of things you could build with this. I'd like to close with a reminder of our contest. Once we reach 2,000 subscribers, I'll be giving away this bushcraft knife that we built in another video. That's right guys, it's still here and it's waiting for one of you. So anything you can do to help, like, comment, share, subscribe. Once we get the channel to 2,000 viewers, I will be giving this knife away to one of my viewers. Thanks for watching the video, guys. I appreciate it. Cheers.